We know that alcohol and cigarettes have a detrimental effect on pregnancy, but have you wondered about the effects of marijuana? It has been estimated that approximately 50% of females who are marijuana users continue to use marijuana during their pregnancy. This raises the question, what effects do cannabis use have during a pregnancy? In the past two decades, there has been an increase in the proportion of pregnant women reporting marijuana use. But it's important to understand why someone might use marijuana in the first place and gain a better understanding of the situation at hand. Some women may feel inclined to use cannabis during their pregnancy, as it is known to relieve common symptoms such as nausea and vomiting. However, many individuals are not aware of the health risks that cannabis may have on a mother's unborn child. Regardless of your personal choice in the matter, it is vital that you educate yourself on some of the risks involved and put your best foot forwards. Unfortunately, researchers today do not have a clear understanding of marijuana's long-term effects, how it works in our body, and how marijuana might affect our genetic code. THC, the main active compound in marijuana, is thought to be responsible for most of the mental and physical alterations one experiences. While we are unsure exactly how THC functions within the body and the brain, a study has shown that injecting a pregnant mother with THC results in an equal amount of THC in the bloodstream of both the mother and the fetus. Once in the bloodstream of the baby, the drug can affect the process of brain development. The use of cannabis can affect cannabinoid receptor cells. These receptor cells are found throughout the body and play a role in one's mood, pain, and memory. With the use of marijuana, alternate signaling pathways can be developed in the brain and can potentially affect the personality, emotions, and the way an individual thinks. In the case of cannabinoids, researchers have found a link between maternal use of marijuana during pregnancy and the way that these receptor cells function and change in the development of a baby. Although this link between cannabis and receptor changes often result in negative effects, we should always be critical of making final judgments. Perhaps the negative effects of cannabis are weighed against positive effects that we currently do not know of. Needless to say, it is always better to err on the side of caution. Let's take a look at a timeline of effects that cannabis might have on a baby's development all the way into adulthood. Mothers who smoke cannabis throughout pregnancy were found to have newborn babies with lower birth weights and reduced dopamine receptor levels. These same children would move on to present with reduced verbal reasoning skills, as well as impaired short-term memory. Additionally, children were at higher risk for showing anxiety, depression, impulsivity, inattention, and hyperactivity. Moving into adolescence, we see a reduction in abstract reasoning skills and a further increase in depressive symptoms, as well as antisocial and delinquent behaviors. At the last stage of development, adults exhibit a reduction in their visuospatial memory abilities and are significantly more likely to show signs of drug-seeking behaviors. Current research indicates a potential relationship between marijuana exposure and a child's intelligence. Mothers who smoked a joint a day or more during their first trimester were shown to have children with, on average, a deficit in the ability to understand concepts and logically express them through words. Smoking throughout the second and third trimester resulted in a lessened understanding of mathematics and the ability to apply mathematical concepts to the real world. Additionally, second trimester cannabis use further includes a reduction in cognitive functioning and short-term memory. This effect was shown to result in an average 5-point reduction of a child's IQ by the time they turn 6 years old. Most importantly, these cognitive deficits range in intensity and effect based primarily on the level of exposure to marijuana. Not only is the timing of marijuana usage important to the child's development, but so is the amount of marijuana smoked. So what can pregnant mothers do? According to the research that is currently available, it is recommended to avoid smoking cannabis throughout pregnancy. However, if a mother does choose to smoke cannabis, it is probably best to avoid use during the first trimester in particular, as smoking during this trimester has been shown to have the greatest negative effect on the development of a fetus. As these effects are dose-dependent, by smoking less cannabis, the effects are also less severe. Overall, cannabis is widely seen as a harmless drug, yet much of the science behind it is unclear and needs to be further investigated. However, its use during pregnancy is not advised due to the facts that we have just explored together. We hope that if you are an expecting mother, this new information can help you make an informed decision.